Hello, I'm Chaplain Robert Terrell, and this is your Monday Motivator. When I was a kid, my dad loved to collect bottles. Milk bottles, soft drink bottles, medicine bottles, any old bottle he could get. And he had some fascinating ones. And one day while I was scavenging, I found a Civil War milk bottle, which was incredible. I cannot believe that I found it. I was 12 years old, still can't believe I found it. It was just there and found it. And my dad was thrilled. It became his pride and joy. Until 3 weeks after I had gotten it, I was bouncing a Super Ball. If you know what those are, the little rubber balls that just bounce way all over the place. And I bounced it in the room that the milk bottle was. And it knocked it off the ledge it was on, and it fell to the ground and broke. I was really scared because my dad just was thrilled with this bottle. And I tried to hide it. Maybe you can relate, okay? So often, instead of facing up when we make a mistake, we try to hide from it. It was a worse situation because of the fact that I tried to hide from that. Eventually, my dad just said, you know, you found the bottle for me. It was a gift. I can't be too mad at this circumstance. But I was eaten up on the inside because I didn't face the problem, and I made it out to be worse than what it was. Before I chaplained for Home Instead, I chaplained for a credit union. And regularly we would have customers come in and they would just be eaten up because they had overdrafted their account several times. And when you asked them what happened, they said, well, I thought something was wrong and I didn't look at my account. People typically don't look at their checking and savings accounts when they're worried that there's not resources there. My faith teaches me that we should confess our sins to one another and pray for one another that we might be healed. Now, our mistakes typically are not sins, okay? But I do think what my faith says there still relates because we all make mistakes. You're going to drop the ball every now and then. I would love to tell you I've never dropped the ball, but I've dropped the ball more times than I care to admit. And it's usually so much better for us when we own up to that and face the problem. Quite often we find out it was not as big a deal as we thought it was, or we find out that there are ways that we can fix that situation. But if we don't face the problem, we never find that out. One of the attributes of love, the verb, is accountability. Accountability means that we do what we say we're going to do, but it also means that when we don't do it, or we're not able to do it, or we forgot to do it, we own up to that. I think it works out best for us, for our clients, and for everyone else around us. So let's own up to our mistakes. Let's be accountable because we want to love one another. I hope you never make a mistake, but if you do and you need to talk with someone about it, please know you can reach out to me anytime. You can call me, you can email me, you can message me. You can also subscribe and like this video. And I hope you have an absolutely wonderful week, okay? Remember, our CEO cares for you, and so do I.